This book of mine was published very recently in English. I understand that it is soon to be translated into Polish. The title, Fashion, Faith and Fantasy in the New Physics of the Universe, was a title I gave to three talks I gave in Princeton about 13 years ago, so it took me a long time to write the book up. The three topics are to do with physical theories, which are very prevalent these days, and with which I have certain reservations. One of them is string theory, that is the fashion, which is still fashionable, although not quite so fashionable as it was when I took on the project. But it's the complaint I have mainly is not so much that string theory does not have any implications which are testable with current technology, but also that the main problem I have with it is that it requires space to have more dimensions than the three that we experience. And in my view, if space had more than three dimensions, there would be very grave problems with trying to make it mirror the universe we know. And this depends on some mathematical difficulties which I discuss in the book. The faith is a much more important theory in physics, namely, this is quantum mechanics. Quantum mechanics, quite unlike string theory, has huge numbers of implications which are explained by the theory and which we see in the current physical world. So there's no question about quantum mechanics being an excellent theory. The faith, however, is that this theory applies at all levels. So this is the problem that Schrödinger pointed out with his cat. So he said, if the theory is correct according to his own equation, you could have a cat that was alive and dead at the same time, and this is nonsense. So there must be something wrong at some level with the theory. So this is the argument that I make there. The fantasy had to do with ideas of cosmology, most particularly the inflationary theory of cosmology, which is a current important essential feature of current cosmology. If inflation is not correct, which currently I believe, I don't think that the inflationary, this was a phase which was supposed to have taken place in the first, 10 to the minus 32 seconds. That's a tiny, 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 tiny fraction of a second which this universe was supposed to have expanded in this exponential way. And I have the view that this doesn't explain many of the features it's supposed to explain. But on the other hand, it does have a role in current cosmology, which has to be replaced, if it's not there, by the scheme which I do describe briefly in this book, which is my concept of conformal cyclic cosmology, according to which the Big Bang was not the beginning, but there was, prior to the Big Bang, an expanding universe, and prior to that, that had a Big Bang, and there was another expanding universe before that. The universe in my scheme never collapses. There are other theories where the universe goes through cycles. In my scheme, it never does that. But it's hard to explain that, certainly, in a few words. But these ideas of mine are also described in the book, in the fourth chapter, where I show that there are alternatives to the fashionable or the faith that we have in quantum mechanics at all levels, and the fantasy, which I believe is not, it's my own fantasy, which I describe also in the final chapter of the book.